Anytime you fire bullets downrange through air, they experience resistance to that flight. That essentially is the drag in layman's terms. And if a bullet shape is such that that drag varies, in other words, shot number one has a little, feels more resistance than shot number two or shot number three, they don't go in the same spot. One will go a little higher, one will go a little lower on the target.
For many years, I personally suffered from vertical flyers. You'll be shooting and everything's perfect. The bullets are just stacking right on top of each other and then one just goes high. And you go back to shooting and they're right back on top of each other and then one goes low. It was something had happened and I couldn't attribute to why it happened. And so when we got to the bottom of this, it was a huge sigh of relief for me. It was one more piece of the puzzle that now we can measure and account for and fix.
So historically, it's known that the shape of projectiles influence the drag, specifically the size of the meeplat, of the nose. What you don't find out there is the effect of the shape on the consistency shot to shot to shot. And that's what we dug into.
We kind of went back to first principles. We went back to the basics of bullet drag and how fast they slow down and the time of flight, and built up from there to try to solve the problem and figure out where these anomalies were coming from. And we started seeing some strange behavior in bullets every once in a while using our Doppler radar that kind of defied the way it should work. It shouldn't happen that way, but we were seeing it, and the data was real and it was believable. Something was happening that should not be happening if everything was normal.
So I remember vividly the day that we were testing when it kind of all came together. We had built projectiles on the same tools, same dies, same materials, and we built some that were very pointy, and then some we took the same projectiles and just machined a small flat on the nose of those. And we shot those in the same rifles, same day, same conditions, side by side. And the ones that had the machined flat on them were perfect from a drag variability standpoint. So when you flatten off a meeplat, the formation of the bow shockwave is such that it is very consistent. And when a bullet's flying downrange through the air, it's pushing that shockwave, it's compressing the air in front of the bullet. So when they're very, very pointy, the formation of that shockwave is inconsistent. Well, then you get inconsistent drag of those projectiles downrange. So after that day of testing, we knew that we had to change the tip geometry on our projectiles.
When we saw that initial kind of clue that this was the direction we needed to go down, we did a substantial amount of different testing to define what was optimal, where did the best performance exist between the shape and the size. And that was really a pursuit in drag variability reduction.
So in order to reduce the drag variability of bullets, through all the testing we did, they need to be flat. And then there's an optimum diameter of the nose in relationship to the diameter of the projectile that gives you very good net drag, but also gives you optimum drag consistency or reducing the variability. So that ratio of the diameter of the bullet to the nose is critical, but it also must be flat as well.
The drag variability reduction technology is really a perfect ratio between shape and size. And in defining that, we realized that this wasn't well understood. There was any data out there on it. It was essentially something new. And so we were able to file and be granted a patent for those two ratios and the specific impact that has on projectile aerodynamics, in specific the consistency of them.
Once we came to grips with how this tip works and the dimensions on the tip, we immediately made the change to heat shield tips. And then we designed the A-tip, and then anything that we're developing that needs a heat shield tip, that's gonna be a longer range bullet. Anything past that 400 yard range is gonna have a heat shield tip and the new tip design.
So what's it all about? When you're shooting, you're looking for consistency. Everything that you're using to make those shots has to be of the highest quality and has to be consistent. With the new patented drag variability reduction technology, we're delivering you that consistency that provides you inherent accuracy shot after shot.
This drag variability reduction technology really is a modern advancement in ballistics, and we don't see that very often. It may seem like a small change to some, but that's a huge addition to the field of ballistics, to the performance, and to your capabilities when you're laying behind the rifle.
So we're a bullet company. Fundamentally, that is where Hornady came from. We make bullets, lots of them, every shape, size, and configuration that you come up with. We didn't need a Doppler radar and a high-speed camera, and we don't need to let these guys go out and do this stuff. We could just make bullets. But that isn't pushing the envelope for ourselves, for our customer, for the industry. We're gonna continue to push the industry and the boundaries of design until we actually do make the absolute most perfect bullet ever manufactured. That's what we're trying to do.